Joe, you and I actually have a few things in common. One, and obviously you guys are the biggest power throwing couple. So I will start out with Ashley. So now you've been the coach, I believe, for two U.S. national teams now.
I was throws coach for the world team for the men. 2018, I did NACAC. In 2017, I did junior Pan Ams for the women. And then I did the world championships for the men.
So you were an 11-time All-SEC honors athlete. You competed in two Olympic trials, 2008, 2012. Any rate, introducing Joe, obviously Joe, a two-time world champion, Olympic silver medalist, so technically a three-time world medalist, two-time world champion, two-time U.S. champion. I think there's some very unique things in terms of, as a coach, how you would feel about that. Not only is this the athlete you're coaching, this is your husband.
To recap Doha, you kind of have to recap the whole process of getting there. She was named the coach in November, around this time last year, for the Doha team. Super excited for her, but at the same time, as you know, USA's isn't easy, and I had to punch that ticket, so we weren't really able to kind of even celebrate that fully until I got that done in Des Moines. So it was definitely exciting just to be there in Doha with her. By the time we got to Doha, just to sum it up, like, we kind of hit the ground running. She had to be there early because she was the team coach, so I got there the same time she did. We strung together some of the best training I think I've ever done in my life. I'll tell you, when you asked, you just brought up the qualifier for me, I'll be brutally honest, I hate the qualifying round more than anything. I probably did something that was crazy, especially if people who know me and know me about warming up and how many warm-ups I've taken. And this was the first time that the A and the B group weren't going at the same time. Normally it's two rings at once and they let them go. So I actually heard that the A group got five throws in the ring for warm-ups. Okay. So by the time I got out there, I did two stand throws, kind of just to start warming up, assuming I'm gonna have three fulls. And I actually only took one full. And they cut us off at three. It was a little unfair that one group got more than the other.
Yeah. For you, Ashley, was there any, like, did you go into that too as the coach thinking, oh, we'll go through your warm-up routine? And I always know, as the right as the coach, it's always gotta be like, oh yeah, everything's fine, even though you might be dying inside. You can't tell your athlete, holy shit, like, I'm stressed. It's like, yeah, it's no big deal. So did you have any of that too?
Yeah, I didn't like it. I knew that they were cutting it close on time. And I knew too that it was gonna be dependent upon, like, how quickly the guys walked, like, through the tunnel to get to the stadium. His first full throw was pretty good, but I know that in the past he's really judged himself for the day based off how his warm-ups were. So I was a little bit apprehensive about that. Luckily, Joe came through in veteran fashion and saved us on that one.
Obviously, Walsh opens with a huge throw. 2090 opener. I think in a lot of competitions, right, most people could really easily mentally shut down. Like, shit, this is done. You kind of build, you get two throws, what, 2194, 2195. You're just kind of building up throughout the whole competition. I mean, this is like the kid dream scenario, right? I got one final throw. I got my last chance to win the whole thing. And clearly you put it together and you go from fourth place, you leapfrog everybody, you hit 2091. I mean, it was just an amazing performance. It's everything you would think. The mindset of an athlete to be in that situation, the amount of pressure that's on, and to be able to come up and hit that throw. What was going through your mind going into that throw?
To be honest, Tom Walsh opening up a 75 feet, I wasn't shocked by that because he had a day between the qualifying and the final, which is unusual. And just the way the season's gone, you know, when that happened, I was ready for that. That's cool. Tom did that. Like, I respect him for throwing 75 feet. It's amazing. But I'm not going to get caught up in that. I would have gotten so caught up with the head-to-head battle and fighting with emotion rather than... So going into the finals, I started to add a little bit more. That kind of changed my mindset. Like, okay, let's go. So by the time we got to the sixth, right after the fifth round, going to the sixth, I walked over to her and she's just like looked at me and said, come away with a PR. And truly, I felt like it was. Every throw felt like I was building and I was checking off the boxes of everything we work in practice. Every throw I took, I had five throws previously that were all kind of like building, even though they weren't as far in terms of execution in the ring. So by the time I sprint out of the back, I'm facing the throw and I release the ball, I scream like crazy off of a reaction. And in that moment, I did not think I won. Like, I wanted to stress that because people think, oh, you think you won. I didn't know if I won. I knew I executed everything. Now, of course, when I ran over the stands, I think I yelled at her and I told her I loved her. But when we turned around after that, and when I saw 91, the first place next to it, yeah, I even yelled a little bit louder crazy because Ryan and Tom still had a throw after me, even Romani too. With Ryan coming back and throwing 22.90 almost for the win, if he would have bumped me off, like, I would have had crazy amount of respect for him. It's a hell of an accomplishment. So I was just happy to be part of that competition and happy, like.
But the real thing is mindset. It's one of those things where people sometimes, when you talk about mindset, they go, yeah, that's cool, but